What is going on, Risen Esports? Tonight, my name is Ryan, and I'll be casting with Lord Clue. We have a very special series going on here. We'll be going with RMT Solar versus Cardi Bliss Empire. We're actually just about to jump into the pick bands here. And I'd like to talk to my good old casting partner to see, ask him what he wants to see this game.
Hello.
Spicy series. Hello, my man.
So, with very little background info on these teams, I'd love to see the Cardi Bliss Empire really show me why they're the Cardi Bliss Empire, personally.
All right. Yeah, I mean, I myself am very bad at this, but I don't pay attention to the leagues that even this league, which I used to play in, believe it or not, until my team dropped out week two. But yeah, we do just... While we're working out the pick ban here, because these, I believe, are not the correct bans. We'll get it sorted out in a second. I want to see some spicy picks with this meta, because we're in the preseason right now. And, I mean, you can know what happens in the preseason. It is a mess. It has always been a mess. Preseasons are the best and the worst time to play League of Legends, because that's when everybody's trying to figure out the meta. I would like to remind everybody that we will not be seeing Nico because she is,
it's unfortunate.
She's not allowed in. She's banned for the first week. Maybe next week we'll see some Nico unless it gets banned out. But, yeah, no Nico. But, we could be seeing, you know, some of the common picks like, Dark Harvest, Karthus bot lane. Who knows? I mean, this is the Gold League, so they are very infamous for making spicy picks like that.
I've definitely seen the Dark Harvest card this bot lane before. Had some experience with that, and let me just say, if it's good, it's good. And if it's not, it's so bad.
Yeah.
And it's really fun to play with.
It's very coin flippy. It's very it can be great to play against, it can be terrible, but if it looks like the first pick going in for RMT Solar is going to be a Lucian, a very, very solid pick. Has been for the majority of this season and continues to be so. So definitely a fan of that, and we are going to see what Cardi Bliss Empire will follow it up with, and they're immediately looking like, yeah, they're going to take away the infamous bot lane duo, and they're going to grab up the prom for themselves.
Yeah, very, very solid response. Almost you have to do that at this point, just because of how strong Lucian and Braum is.
Yeah. No, exactly. That lane is deadly. And, I mean, they synergize so well together. That lane's been so good for so long for a reason, right? Like, you have to respect it. Lucian gets picked. I mean, hey, Braum's still a solid support on his own, so. But we are going to see the Caitlyn picked up by Bard One Trick. Caitlyn is an interesting pick this split. I mean, I feel like it's been doing okay in the preseason, being commonly paired with Grasp. So we'll see. We'll see. Caitlyn's been quite weak, but hey, can always do good. And then the Leona. Leona picked up for RMT Solar. So there we go. We already get to see our bot lane duel. It's both teams prioritizing the bottom side of the map here.
Yeah, I definitely got to say, if Lucian and Leona can get that early lead going, I think this Caitlyn is really going to struggle to keep up.
Definitely. I 100% agree with that. I mean, obviously, Caitlyn will have the range on top of Lucian, but that doesn't matter if the Leona's, you know, on top of you, CCing down, just being a nuisance. And we do actually see the Victor and the Sion picked up. The Victor picked up for Cardi Bliss Empire. That can definitely be flex top or mid, so we'll see where that goes. And I think it's safe to assume that it's going to be Sion in the top.
I mean, Sion definitely has been seen as a mid lane counter pick to some assassins before, but definitely think as a blind pick, it is going to be headed top lane.
Yeah, definitely. Sion's a good pick. You know, he's one of those, as a top laner myself, those tanky messes that you just, you don't want to go against because they're just anti-fun. But hey, you know, it's definitely, he's a good team fighter. His passive has always been incredibly strong. And you know what? I tell this every time I see a Sion, at least it's not old Sion.
As someone who's been a newer player, not been around the league scene quite as long, I've only known this Sion, and let me just say, he is a pain in the butt at times.
Yeah, you know what? I'd go into detail about old Sion, but I don't want to do that right now. I don't want those memories in my mind.
You don't want to bring up those flashbacks?
No, not at all. So we're just gonna leave it as it is. But
probably a good idea.
Running through the second go of bans now, and now we actually see Skarner picked up for Cardi. Pretty solid pick there. I'm a fan of Skarner.
I think this Skarner, the Braum, that's a lot of CC that you can pair up. I think that's a pretty solid pick.
Definitely, yeah. With the Victor, with the Caitlyn, all of that, they're definitely going to be going for a bit of a pick composition here by the looks of it. And then, is it going to be a Graves? It is a Graves. Graves picked up by RMT Solar. Whew, that is a strong pick. I am a little surprised that made it through the bans.
So is Graves still really strong this preseason? I haven't been able to keep up as much recently with it.
Yeah, especially with Dark Harvest. And I mean, Riot keeps nerfing Dark Harvest, but it doesn't matter. You know, just the changes that they did with Dark Harvest, like, it's gonna be a strong keystone forever now. And yeah, it pairs incredibly well with Graves. Usually started off with like a Stormraiser, and it's immense damage. It's so hard to deal with. And the final two picks we are gonna see for the mid laners, so it is gonna be a Victor top. We are gonna see a Fizz picked up for Homie, and the Lux picked up for Tyler is Success.
If I'm the Lux there, I am really scared of that lane. Once that Fizz and that Skarner hit 6, that is going to be very hard to avoid that Genghis Lux if you can't land that first CC spell on that Fizz.
Yeah. Sorry, one second. All right, and it is my favorite part of the game. I don't know, whenever I cast, I like to just, you know, take a quick look at loading into the game, which isn't gonna load in for me. Please don't give me any technical issues. We're good. All right, perfect. We had a look at the good old keystones to talk about if we see anything out of the blue. And I'm looking at it right now, and it's pretty normal. Graves actually opting to go for Fleet Footwork instead of Dark Harvest, so that that strat I was talking about earlier is obviously we're not going to see it, but Graves still is just a strong champion. He's not completely decided on his keystone, so it should still be fine. And then other than that, nothing else, nothing crazy.
One thing I am a little concerned about, though, is that Lux did opt to go for that Arcane Comet instead of that Dark Harvest. So while that does give you that early lane pressure against the Fizz, feel like that's really going to hurt her scaling into this Brahma and Skarner that are both going to be big tanks late game.
Yeah, definitely. Neversaw is actually quite infamous for his Lux pick. He is an incredibly strong Lux player, and he will always say that it is his strongest champion. So I'm going to have to believe that there is a reason in his mind to take Comet instead of Dark Harvest. But hey, we'll have to wait and see. I trust in the Lux player. I trust in my man.
I'm ready. Impress me.
Definitely. We're just we're waiting for the final people to load in on the stream side here. It is, in fact, Mr. Neversaw that is holding us up here. But yeah, we'll talk about team comps. So the two team comps that we see, what do we think? Who's going to come out on top? Just team comp orientated.
Just based off of the pretty strong early game, and then at the same time, the late game scaling with the Graves, I am going to have to go ahead and give it to the blue team, I think. I just think that they can overwhelm early game, and even if they don't, they have solid scaling in the Graves and the Scion.
Yeah, definitely. I can agree with that. They have the snowballing champions. They have the early game. They have the Scion to back them up to be a little tanky. And I mean, on the other side, they have Braum as their tank, which is definitely a good, like, support. He can back you up with a whole lot of CC and a whole lot of tankiness. But other than that, they've gone through a really, as I stated before, in the champ select, more of a pick-orientated composition. Going off that Skarner engage and then pairing it with probably, the Braum or the Victor ultimate. And then they have the Fizz in there as well. To kind of back it off as damage, but Fizz loses in lane, he might struggle a bit, which yeah, theoretically he shouldn't into the Lux, but you never know.
That is my biggest concern in this game. I think that this game for Red Side resides on this Fizz getting ahead and this Skarner really abusing this Lux.
Yeah, definitely. So I would expect, I'm gonna have to say, quite a bit of play around the mid lane for the red side, because it's definitely going to what they want. They're going to want that Fizz, which is going to be a main source of their damage, or a huge source of the damage, we'll say, to go. I mean, they always have Victor. Victor is a, that man does a lot of damage. But I am going to quickly introduce the teams to everybody. I'll grab the blue side, and once I'm done screaming out the names for the blue side, you can go ahead and just introduce the red side. Oh, I shouldn't have picked the blue side because that Scion's name is already giving me a little bit of anxiety, though. Count Riara on the Scion, Borden 23 on Graves, Neversaw the Lux main on his own champion Luck, Tyler Successor Lucian, and Bang Bus Driver on Leona.
Then quickly over to the other side. Here we have Bliss on Caitlyn, Cardi on that Braum, Exhelmy on the Victor, Bard One Trick on Skarner, and Fried Chicken Leg on Fizz.
There we go. All righty. We just see some pretty basic starts for either team. Both opting to start on the bot side of the map. No crazy invades. A little boring for us, but hey, who knows? We're going to just see some basic starts. I want to pay attention to the vision game early on because that's quite important. You know, you gotta pay attention to where those jungles are, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. It looks like both teams did end up placing down that double river ward, so that's good to see.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. I am curious to see who or what jungler is going to be more prevalent, because as we discussed before, we would like to see the Skarner playing around in the mid lane, but, you know, he's also Skarner. His kit doesn't really pick up until level 6. It's one of the main reasons why he's not super commonly picked, because it's hard to just kind of play a champion just around one ability. And I find a lot of people kind of just find themselves playing Skarner that way, although it is not the only way to play Skarner. And then there's Graves, who is, he can be a very aggressive early game jungle, and I hope to see that being the case here. You know, he has fleet footwork, he has the kiting ability to kind of, like, kite out these champions while he's, you know, doing work, so I'm definitely gonna say, keep an eye out on these two junglers this game, because hopefully that's where the action's gonna revolve around.
Yep, absolutely. I'd love to see this blue team get great vision deep in this red jungle and really keep that Lux safe. I think that's up to the Graves there to get those invades and bot lane to back him up.
Yeah, definitely, for sure. And then again, I'd like to still kind of point out the bot lane as we're looking at right now, because, I mean, like, Lucian, Leona, if they get the upper hand, like, that Caitlyn, Braum, they're just going to fall, and they're going to fall hard. But I have a feeling, you know, it's going to go the other way, too. But as we see right now, Borden, 23, is going, burns the flash of Exhomi, but he's going to go for the dive under tower. He is tanking. He doesn't get the kill. Flash blown for Borden, flash blown for Homie.
Absolutely outstandingly played by the victor there. Went right to that turret to block those grave shotgun chills. Very well played.
Yeah, that was incredibly smart, but there we go. I do want to see more of that. Get some action going on. Definitely a solid attempt out of Borden. That is going to be quite helpful. I always think trading jungler's flash for a laner's flash is nice because now, you know, that Sion's going to have a bit of an easier time, you know. The victor isn't going to be able to escape as well. So I think that's quite worth it for the blue side there.
Absolutely. The biggest issue that I have with that is a fed Sion is really just a tanky Sion. Whereas if you camp this bot lane and get this Lucian going, you got a much better chance for success.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. I mean, unless he goes for the classic, you know, int Sion, which...
Uh-oh.
I don't know if we've if Risen has seen the likes of int Sion quite yet, but you never know. Yeah, I would like to see it. Yeah, some action revolved in the bot lane of the map because I do have a feeling that these is where the two carries are going to be. But then again, I would like to bring attention to Neversaw in the mid lane on his Lux. I have seen this kid play Lux, and I have seen him smash diamonds with said Lux.
Wow.
He should not be underestimated. But here we go. We do see an engagement from Bangwest Driver. A lot of damage going on to Cardi. But there we go. Bliss doing a lot of damage to Bangwest Driver as well. The two of them are going to be forced to back up. But first blood will be picked up by Bangwest Driver.
Yeah, went over to the Leona. But nonetheless, it is a first blood with some spawn on both sides. So that's big.
Yes, exactly. And I mean, while Tyler is success, he still has both his sums. I mean, Caitlyn blue heal and the Braum blue ignite. So there we go. That's a good step ahead, and this Exhomi, he's taken a good bit of damage. Count Riara is he's just doing Sion things. Sorry about that. We're just figuring out the stream there, but here we go. Ult dropping off onto Neversaw there. He is going to take a lot of damage, and he falls. That is Neversaw going down. Fizz picking up a kill. And now we are going to see a gank attempt on the bot lane. Bangbus Driver getting the stun off onto Cardi, but he's taking a lot of damage, and Flash is going to have to be blown there. Well, there we go. There's some action. That is what we need to see.
Yeah, just a quick recap of that overall. I do love to see that Graves come bot lane and really attempt to get this Lucian ahead. But the Lux did not respect that level 6 Fizz engage, and Fizz got 6 first, and it's really hard to counter that, and had to blow both sums and still died.
Yeah, definitely. I'm going to have to need you to just kind of take control of the stream for a second. I believe in you, my man. I need to think up with the streamer here, so don't mind me.
Hold on. Quickly, not too much to look at right here. This ocean is still up, but neither team has really moved towards it at all to look for that early ocean, which has been rather surprising. He's going to go ahead and pick up that Sheen as well. That's a pretty big power spike for him. While it doesn't give the AP, it does give the really strong engages with that Sheen proc.
Yeah, definitely. And we do see the ultimate going off from the Caitlyn there. Not much going on, but... Okay, I think I've synced up. I want to say I have synced up. I'm trying to figure this out here. Not quite. Come on now. Alright, yeah, we're synced up. I figured it out. Alrighty. Okay, yeah, so we saw some action going on. Excuse my technical difficulties, but it is all sorted out now. Now we're going to talk about what just happened. We do see a bit of a small 200 gold lead for the red side. Pretty still an even game. I don't see any crazy gold leads, just a little bit on the Fizz and a little bit on the Caitlyn. So that's kind of where their gold lead is coming from. But yeah, good attempts. Still only 1-1, so tied in kills. But we'll see. The CS might be able to take over this game because we all know what happened with the preseason. It's not all about kills now. It's all about that spicy CS, so you can get those bounties.
Yeah, absolutely. One thing I am a little concerned about, though, just like we were talking about in the pregame about how this Fizz needs to snowball, this Lux, to a certain extent, not quite as much since she has the shield and the root, mm-hmm. but she still needs to snowball as well, and especially being down 15 CS and a kill early. That could definitely turn into a problem.
Definitely. Bit of a scrimmage coming down in the bot lane here, looks like, his Fizz is going to walk down. But is anything going to happen of it? No, it doesn't. Team realizes, they seize it, and they back off. So there it is. Fried chicken leg trying to do something there. But here we go. We see...
Sorry, Sun's not
a little ahead again. No, there we go. We are going to watch it, though. We're going to see what was ahead. Boom, there we go. Never saw getting yoinked up and getting double ulted. That's a whole lot of damage, and he will fall. There it is. That is another kill for that Fizz. That's what we're talking about. He's going to need those kills to snowball and get strong, and he's getting it. Oh, and here we go. We see the Sion ult dropping onto Skarner. He is in the middle of a giant mess. He's taking a whole lot of damage from Fried Chicken Leg. He's here to back him up. He's doing a whole lot of damage to Borden. Borden flashed to force the flash off. But oh my goodness, Bard one trick. Banking it away. No, he does not. Borden.
Nice.
Oh, that is a incredible ultimate. He hits that snipe and manages to pick up a kill for himself.
Yeah, Graves managing to right the ship a little bit there and start to pick up that slack for his team with the slacks falling behind.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to see one of these teams really start to move towards these objectives. We're 10 minutes in and haven't really had any other team show yet.
Yeah, definitely. We are just kind of seeing some like pretty basic skirmishes here. It looks like the Graves is going to want to make a bit of a play himself. He's trying for it. He's going to take a lot of damage, but no. Fizz just uses Fledge Swings, gets that playful trickster, and he's out of there.
Yeah, you love to try and help that Lux get back in the game, but so hard to gank a Fizz with that playful trickster. So slippery.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And finally, I am not going to be behind anymore. I am all 100% caught up.
We good?
We are all good, yes.
Leave it alone. Outstanding.
Thank you, finally. All right. So good. Yeah, I want to say good play in the jungle there. Finding Bard one trick kind of caught out. And now hopefully they can be able to use that to get that Graves scaling a bit. Never saw. I mean, Fizz is a bit of a hard matchup into him. But I think Lux, you know, Lux can just do Lux things. Lux is strong. We are going to see him force the blow flash. And he actually manages to hit the snipe off onto the thing. But he overextends. He's hit by the Fizz ultimate now. But a good hourglass or stopwatch, let's say, saves his life.
Absolutely. It's fortunate to have to blow that stopwatch that early, getting a little greedy in that re-engage there, but if you got the stopwatch, you gotta use it, you know?
Yeah. He saw he hit Bard one trick. He's like, I got the Skarner, I got that Scorpion, I'm gonna go in for it. And Fizz saw that and was like, no, you stay away from my jungler. So I want to say good play from the Fizz, also a good play from Neversaw, managing to escape with his life from that. And yeah, let's just see, like, let's see what the Lux manages to do. Pretty slow game. You know, only 4 kills at 12 minutes. But hey, you know, some teams opt to go in for that.
Yeah, critically, no more ways to survive these ganks for the Lux. Lose stopwatch and flash. It's going to be very difficult to repeat one.
He's going to want to try and finish his hourglass pretty quickly, but he's looking like he's opting for the Loon's Echo first. But now we do see an engage onto the bot lane, and that is a whole lot of damage. Bang Bus Driver managing to pick up the second kill onto Hardy. That is another kill onto the support there. Lucian, at some point, is going to want to start taking those for himself, but that is okay, because this is going to give them the opportunity to go for the dragon.
Yeah, absolutely. I love this calling. It's a great call. You get that early sustain to help up in that top lane as well, where the Victor won't hurt the Sion, and then with the bot lane, where they can do more active trading, look to be more proactive.
Yes, exactly. The Ocean Drake is just a fantastic Drake to have on tanks, and Sion is just gonna be loving that. And there we go, the good old turret plating call. I'm still not used to that, but hey. Turret plating will fall soon. We have not seen a tower fall onto the plating. I wanna actually just take a second. Who has the most platings? As a matter of fact, the blue side doesn't even have one plating for themselves. That is why red side is actually a little bit ahead in gold. They have two platings to zero platings. Alright, we do see now they are gonna go for that good old Rift Herald picked up by the red side. That'll help them out grab a tower, which will be very nice because now the turret plating is down.
Yeah, so, very nice objective trade there.
Mm-hmm.
Smart macro.
Yep. Once they're able to kind of make a play on the side of the map, I think that Skarnery is just going to wander to the opposite side of the action, drop a little Heraldy down, and get a whole lot of gold. Actually, not as much gold, but a whole lot of objectives, we'll say.
A solid amount of gold.
It's still decent. It's not as great as it was before, because the majority of gold comes from the plating. We do see the ultimate going out for Bliss, which is going to give the opportunity to them to try to engage. But Bangless Driver hitting a crazy ultimate, but the shield is just taking the majority of that culling damage. And in the meanwhile, we see a play on the bot side of the, or the top side of the map. X-Homie taking a whole lot of damage from that Sion and the Graves. Alt coming out, manages to pick up the kill. Once again, fantastic ultimate coming down from Borden 23. Saw that stuff was going down in the bot lane and managed to make the play top. And Fizz missing the ultimate here. Never saw landing the good snare, doing a whole lot of damage. And once again, even more damage in the bot lane. Bliss is low, but so is Taj Success. But no, he manages to come out on top of that trade. Cardi, will he manage to escape? He does. Takes a little bit of damage from the towers. Little Bangbus driver there. But no, that's a positive trade. And now they're getting immense turret damage on the top side of the map and the bot side of the map.
So much action that we just witnessed there.
Yeah.
Very proactive play from blue side, and you gotta love to see it, even if they weren't quite able to pick up that kill on that Fizz.
Mm-hmm. I would like to say that they saw after that whole engage in the top lane, they saw the Skarn was there to try and back him up. And the bot side realized that Tyler's success in Bangbus Driver, so they took that opportunity, took out Bliss, and got a good chunk of turret damage down. And once again, I mean, a fantastic play I never saw. Unfortunate it didn't pick up the kill for himself because Fizz just doing Fizz things. But still, that's going to help him out in the long run. He's caught up and farm a decent amount.
Yeah, this Graves is starting to get scary. He's completed that warrior enchant. Can move on to finishing up these boots soon. And he's going to be doing massive damage. I'm sure he's sitting on quite a bit of gold right now as well. I mean, very scary to see what happens with that Graves.
Mm-hmm. Graves is gonna start doing Graves things, because like I said, you know, if he had Dark Harvest, he would be doing a whole lot of chunks, but Graves is not very reliant on said summoners, are like the Keystones. He doesn't need them.
Yeah, absolutely. He did give him that early clear, and he was able to get on the map a little bit earlier, but definitely scaling-wise, Dark Harvest would have been the better choice.
Yeah, definitely. We are going to see the Rift Herald drop down mid lane, taking advantage of how strong that Fizz is into Neversaw, because he's not going to be able to do a whole lot. He's going to have to back off, and Braum is going to be there quite soon as well. So it's safe to say this is going to be the tower dropping pretty soon, unless Graves can make the hero play. But here we go, Tyler's success doing a whole lot of damage, and boom, manages to grab the solo kill on the Blitz in the bot lane. So there we go, that is a fantastic trade. They realized that the Braum walked up, and they took advantage of that. They trade tower for kill, and they're going to go for the tower with the entire red side. They're going down. They're going to make sure that they are punished for overstaying. Will it happen? That is a predator being dropped. Is Bangbrush Driver? Yeah, Bangbrush Driver is just going to be the sacrifice. He is saying, hey, take my life so my ADC can't escape.
And yeah, Lucian did get away, though.
Long time to die. Yeah, exactly. Tyler's success made it out, and that Leona just, oof. Took a bit to die there, so very smart play by Bangbus Driver. I commend him on that.
Yeah, but we do see that bot lane start to pull ahead. Lucian 202, before that, Leona was 201. Mm-hmm. Like we said, that Lucian and Leona really starting to get going there.
Yeah, exactly. And that Lucian is going to be huge once he picks up that Bork, which he already has, in fact. That Braum is just going to start becoming paper, and same with the Skarner. So that's going to be very strong. Tyler's success may quite very well hold the key to victory here.
Yeah, absolutely. We do see this Infernal Drake spawning. That is going to be a bigly contested objective here. They'd love to see either team be able to pick up.
Yeah, exactly. No TPs on either side, or like either top laners, so it's probably most likely will be a 4v4 for this dragon if they decide to fight for it. And it looks like they are. They're kind of getting that vision set up. We'll see how this goes. Alt dropped down from Bangwash Driver. Hits Blitz, so she's going to be forced to back away. But Borden tanking that full Fizz ultimate and the Braum ultimate doing a whole lot of damage. And then the ultimate going down onto Tyler's success. That is a double kill for the red side. They're going to keep going. They want more.
Lux they're just gonna
Lux penning a good snare, but that is going to be the Infernal Drake going over to the red side. That is a huge pickup for them.
Yeah, outstanding team fight engage. Great counter engage off the Miss Leon ulti. Good follow up.
Yeah, definitely. Very strong play for Cardi Bliss Empire. They managed to pick up that Infernal, which is going to be good, and they still are a little bit ahead in gold. That Fizz, you know, with that, like that Lich Bane picked up. Whew.
Yeah, big shutdown on him, too. He's got 700 gold bounty right now. Mm-hmm. He's looking mighty big right now. Meanwhile, top lane, we see big wet noodle fight. Absolutely nothing happening on either side.
Oh, yeah, that is the top lane classic. You know, it's like the worst thing is when you're trying to cast a game and the directed camera just decides to just stay orientated to the top side of the map because the two of them are just in an internal wet noodle battle. And directed camera just goes, oh, wow, action going top side. And you're just trying to catch this wet noodle fight going on and nothing happens. It's literally the most boring thing ever. But we do see what is not a wet noodle battle going on in the river there. Borden 23 finding himself trying to fight with the Skarner, but Fizz comes up and just does a whole lot of damage. Gets a Dark Harvest stack, picks up the assist, and that is Borden falling down.
You know, I'm going to say worth though. Sion gets the scuttle. Totally worth.
Sion got the scuttle, worth. Well, there we go. But now we are going to see that top lane tower fall. I don't know, that scuttle. Scuttle couldn't save the tower, unfortunately. I wish it would have, but...
All memes aside, it does get the vision on Baron, which will be really crucial coming up.
Definitely, it is, will be helpful. Because they are going to probably start looking for at least a Baron dance soon, you know. Baron dances usually start kind of happening around 25 minutes in the game.
Yeah, really big at this point. The Lucian needs to be kept alive in team fights. If the Fizz gets on top of him at all, or the Skarner ults him, I think it's just game over for blue team.
Yeah, definitely. And we are going to see Bangbus Driver having to flash out. He does not want to mess with homie on that Victor. Because, hey, Iceborne Gauntlet picked up. That's a lot of slow.
It's a ton of slow.
Yeah, definitely. You have to respect that Victor now. I mean, he's picked up his item. He's going for his second one very soon. I mean, Tank Victor is not something to be messed with. Like, I am a huge, huge fan of that. I am glad it became meta personally. And, you know, maybe because it added a little more excitement to the top lane.
Has Glacial ever been a thing on Victor at all?
No, not really. I mean, you could take it. It's not terrible, but a lot of like people either opt for Klepto. I'm a huge fan like Victor mid lane taking Fleet Footwork. Mm-hmm. But we are gonna see. Yeah, they just. I mean, the tower taking potential with Cardi Bliss Esports with that Caitlyn is very, very big, and we are gonna see Fried Chicken like do a whole lot of damage to Borden. He thought he can get the kill. Will be able to because the stopwatch goes down and no, he falls. The flash Q from Fried Chicken, like, that's that Fizz damage for you. And they're all gonna collapse onto the Sion now. He manages to actually flash away to escape. I was expecting him to have to use his ultimate, but no. That all was flash for his life, and the rest of the team's here to back him up, so maybe they can defend this tower.
Yeah, with Lux LT up, it's very hard to siege. Just so much wave clear on that and such a low cooldown.
Mm-hmm. There we go. Yeah, they're forced to back way. They managed to save the one tower. There we go. And things seem to be kind of falling apart here for RMT Solar. They still have a chance. I mean, they can definitely win a big team fight and get them scaling again. I mean, Neversaw right now is sitting on zero kill participation and two deaths. So once he starts getting around in those team fights, see if they change for the better for them. But I guess time will tell.
Yeah, I feel like this game is really being won around this mid lane. Look at the Fizz, 4-0-3. And even in addition, if we go ahead and look at that vision score, Fizz 21 to Lux is only 12. So it's difficult to get back in that game if you don't know where this Fizz sitting in those bushes is going to be coming out of.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the shutdown gold on Fizz and even Skarner will be a lot of gold to whoever picks it up, which will help him out. I mean, if they manage to pick up both shutdown golds, that should pretty much like tie up the gold back to even or come very close to.
Yeah, crucially, Fizz does have his Zhonya's now, though.
Mm-hmm. Which, I mean, we saw in the last fight how it worked out for him, actually saving his life into that Victor. But here we go. We see a bit of an engage. Akato onto Homie. He's going to try and do whatever he can, but the kiting ability onto Victor is just too strong. He gets away. There's the slow and the empowered Q for you. He's just gone. That man is fast.
And they pick up the dragon as well. Outstanding play by Homie to survive there. And really bait the whole team of Blue Sight over way to really free up that dragon for Cardi Bliss Empire.
Yeah, and that cloud is going to feel very nice on some of the champions over there because they're going to be wanting to rotate over and pick up more objectives. The cloud's just going to assist them into doing that faster. So very smart play by Cardi Bliss Esports and a fantastic job by Homie managing to survive there.
Yeah, you love to see that cloud and that Skarner especially. And even on the Victor kiting away, both two very strong champions to pick up that first cloud with.
Yeah, definitely. I definitely want to see, you know, more plays. You know, Blue Side's going to have to try to pick it up and start going for some objectives themselves. Realize what they can do in the map. I mean, it's tough. These two teams, I would like to say they scale fairly evenly. Nothing really stands out for me.
Yeah, that's fair. I think the only thing that would really stand out late game is the Graves, but even that's matched by the Victor and the Caitlyn.
Yeah,
so it's
exactly.
Hard to say.
Mm-hmm. I think we are going to have a battle, but here we go. They are going and starting up that Baron Dance. Like I said, hey, 25 minutes in the match. Just, I'm too good of a caster with these predictions. They're getting that vision going around, and the dance has started up.
Yeah, like you said earlier, right at the start of this game, Blue Sight is running more of a pick comp, so you'd love to see them take the initiative here and really look to force that fight and get that pick.
Mm-hmm. Get that pick and go for the Baron. I mean, they can try and pressure it as many times as they can. They have the team to do that. So we'll see what happens, but yeah.
Yeah, game's still very in reach. Only a 3k gold lead.
Definitely, yeah. It will just take one fight to even it back up for RMT Solar. And one fight to really extend their lead further for Cardi Bliss Empire. Yeah, very methodical game. Now the red team is going in to clear the vision. Oh, the good old wonderful Baron Dance. I love this.
It's quite the exciting time in the game. It really makes you feel that love for League.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Then hop into your next match and then you're like, why do I play this game?
Yeah, we'll just have to see, you know, both teams, they want the vision on the Baron. It's a major objective. Either team who gets the Baron is going to be massive for them. That'll definitely help the lead. We're just going to have to wait and see which team gets it. Who comes out on top? Right now, the vision is mainly for the red side of the map, and they're backing, actually. Bang, Bus Driver. Don't know. It's a bit of a risky play. You know, all it takes is them to realize that it's like a 4v5 or a 3v5 for them to start up and actually start pressuring that Baron. So very careful at this time of the game. Very careful. Gotta treat it like a baby. And oh, there we go. Good job, Borden, realizing what was going on. But oh my goodness, that is too much damage. The Ignite is just going to try and tick down. That might be enough. And Fizz manages to pick up once again his fifth kill.
Yeah, the door for Baron wide open now with that Graves gun. No smite.
Yeah, exactly. They're going to go straight for that. And RMT Solar are going to have to try and do what they can to stop this, but it's going to be tough. Fight's definitely not in their favor. We'll have to just wait and see if they even attempt to try and stop it. You know, they're making the slow move in. But Cardi Bliss Empire, they realize
too late.
They're zoning off. It is, might in fact be too late. Yeah, they're going to have to back off. They're just giving away this Baron. Neversol tries to go for the steal. Solid attempt. But nope, that is a Baron for Cardi Bliss Empire.
Yeah, great attempt by the Lux there, but at the same time, the Skarner kept his cool, smited. Good execution under pressure.
Yep, very good pickup. That is going to extend their gold lead to 4k and beyond. And that's, like I said, looking pretty dire for RMT Solar in game one here.
I am questioning. I think they've got a decent siege, but with the Fizz, I'm not sure unless they try and dive the turret. Which is very possible with the Skarner and the Braum. Just how much siege they really have when you have that melee mid laner, even if he is fed.
I mean, yeah, and this siege with Caitlyn, though, and Victor is huge. Victor can honestly just stay in the side lane now forever and just consistently pressure, and Caitlyn just roll with the rest of like her team and manage to pick up the objectives elsewhere, you know, wherever Victor isn't. So, the Baron, like, I mean, obviously, no matter what, is a huge pickup, but especially for this team, it's just going to be massive. The pressure is going to be pretty big.
Yeah, that's true. Also, both top winners do have their TPs up, so might just be sitting in the sidelines here.
Yep, definitely. And, like, there it is. Victor's already in the bot side of the map, making moves. And if the blue side tries to go for anything, but we see a huge pickup by Bard One Trick, gets the ult off onto Borden, and he's down. There we go. Now it's a 4v5, and they're just going to do that. Caitlyn's going to do Caitlyn things and start taking away that tower with the Baron minions. Victor still in the bot lane, keeping Sion's attention down there.
Yeah, more flashes below. Both flashes on the bot side.
Mm-hmm. They just need to keep this cannon minion alive, and there it is. Yeah, it takes a tower itself, and they're able to push in further. An absolutely very strong pick. The pick comp is working fantastic for Cardi Bliss Empire. But also, there we go. A bit of a good ultimate by Neversaw to get a little bit of damage on there to kind of force him to disengage. But they're gonna make their way to the bot side of the map now, so. Yeah, just let those three cannon minions do their thing. Oh my goodness. There's just chunk in the towers, and without that Lux ultimate, it's going to be a little difficult for them to clear. Without getting a little too close to the big old damage that the red side has. Bliss dropping an ult in there, trying to chunk him down a little low. Borden is alive, but already half HP. Yo, they just sit still. Let the Baron minions do the thing. And then they're gonna have to sooner or later worry about the mid lane. The super's crashing down, so.
Yeah, absolutely. Ocean Drake is up as well. Another great pickup for a siege comp. Just sit there and stay forever. No need to back when you have an Ocean Drake to heal you up.
Exactly, yeah. Oh, sorry. A little bit of a yawn going on, but another Ocean, yep, being picked up, which will be very handy for them. You know, little old Ocean, he's underrated, but he's quite helpful. HP, you know, it's pretty important in the game. You know, more HP you have, the longer you're able to stay in these fights, and just, you know, when you're out of combat and, you know, passively even just getting a little bit of HP than you normally would, it's handy.
Yeah, absolutely. Especially with this third Drake being picked up by Red Side here, Elder Drake does start to become a huge win condition, where you're just not sure how much longer Blue Side can really hold on if that Elder is eventually picked up.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, first Elder, as strong as it is, I mean, it is not compared to second Elder. So, you know, first Elder gets picked up by, say, you know, Cardi Bliss Esports, they were probably going to manage to get a whole lot out of it. And if they manage to pick up the second Elder with the Drakes that I already have, that's going to be massive. Okay, we're just seeing a bit of a macro game being played right now. Both teams, you know, they don't really want to fight, both for different reasons. I think Cardiblitz Esports, that they know that they can just out macro this team, win the macro game, and just kind of play it safe and slow. And RMT Solar, I think they're thinking that they're not really able to take any fights right now. It's not the time. They don't want to go for a play, make a mistake, and just throw the game even further.
Yeah, very difficult when you are beating Siege on my Baron unless you take that really quick initiative to really continue these fights.
Mm-hmm. And there we go. Here's a little bit of a wet noodle fight we see in the bot lane. Although, Count Yara taking a fair bit of damage. He's going to have to back off there. And Victor should be able to get a decent chunk off on the tower. But now he's got Graves is here to back him up. Will Sion actually... Yep, there he goes. He goes for the ult. Homie having to flash away, but a fantastic stun. Will stall a little bit. He is doing damage. He is actually winning that fight. He manages to pick down Borden. A fantastic play. Will he go for two? He wants it. Kariara is getting insanely low. X homie with the massive outplay manages to pick up that double kill.
Yeah, beautiful play by homie. They're outstanding kiting. Victor, so many slows.
Good pick by Neversaw, but I mean, just the Victor. He's going to be able to push up bot lane now, and there's not much the team can do. And there we go, Bard One Trick ulting up Bangbuzz Driver. And Neversaw, you know, you're a Lux without abilities. What can you do now? He's just taking down. Fried Chicken like wants him, but he actually dies. And there we go. Tyler Success doing what he can, but X Homie is still here in the bot lane doing damage to that inhibitor. That might very well be the second one. No, he falls. Kill picked up by Tyler is Success. They actually managed to save the bot lane inhib.
Yeah, beautiful response. You gotta love the Lucian getting forward and healing that Lux, saving him from the Fizz Engage. It's a big reason that even when you have the Sion, losing the 1v1 in the bot lane, the 1v2, my bad. Because that is a 3v4 fight win right there.
Yeah, definitely. That was a very strong play on either side. I mean, it like Inhibitor picked up for Cardiblitz Esports, which will be, you know, great for them. But, you know, like RMT Solar, they managed to stop what could have been worse, could have been two. Getting, you know, some kills picked up the Lucian, which will make him stronger. You know, he might be able to get more done. He actually did get the shutdown onto the Fizz, which is a whole lot of gold. He's got three items picked up for himself and a BF and a QSS.
Yeah, that's big that the Lucian finally managed to pick up that big kill.
Yeah. Definitely, for sure. This game, I still believe, you know, it is 3 towers to 8. It still could be anyone's game. Both inhibitors are back up. We'll give, you know, a little bit of breathing room for RMT Solar. And that dragon's spawning up in a minute, and Baron is live. So we'll see who makes the plays on these objectives. Obviously, Cardiblitz having that advantage, the upper hand. But who knows? I want to see some spicy stuff happen. Surprise us this game.
I'd love to see that Lux. She's hit that three items. We saw how much damage she does to that Caitlyn in that last fight. She picked him off. That's a big reason why they won that fight. I think if she can pick off this Caitlyn again, or maybe even try for a pick on Fizz, even with his Anya's, I think that's a great way to start off a fight here.
Yeah, any pick would be big. You know, obviously 4v5s would not be favorable with a team for four. So we'll see what goes, but they realize that they have to go back for the minions, kind of defend the base a bit. So they're starting up that Baron right away. RMT Solar realizes, and they're sending their three goons up to stop it, but will they be able to do it? That will be a 3v4 for the Baron. Neversaw kind of trailing a little bit. And yeah, they're staying well safe away from that that Skarner there. And come on, Director Cam, why are you showing us the wet noodle fight when we have some spicy stuff going on in the Baron? A huge culling just doing a whole lot of damage to forced to flash away, but a big ultimate picking up Neversaw. Bliss finding himself very low. Tyler Success manages to pick up the trade kill. I think that's enough to stop him away from getting the Baron, but it's not enough
base,
to stop Xomi from getting their base. Yeah, he might very well pick up the two inhibitors here, which will be massive. Incredibly smart play by him, just staying you know, using his advantage he has over this Sion. And there he goes. That's two.
Yeah, Victor really starting to lay down the pain train on the Sion, and the Elder is up now.
Yeah, and they want it. Exactly, they're going for it. There we go. They're gonna go for that Elder, which will be very, very handy. I mean, they kind of got the trifecta of dragons there. All they're missing is a mountain. So this Elder is gonna double up everything with them, which is, you know, pretty handy. But yeah, Elder Drake started up. I think Borden and Vanquest Driver, do they know? They don't. They're just taking their time. This dragon might be going uncontested.
Does he look for the steal here, though?
Ooh. Tries to steal. I think Deversal was just out of range there. Unfortunate. But yeah, there we go. That's that Elder Drake going over to Cardi Bliss Esports.
I don't know if it was in the attention by the Fizz there, but that was a great zoning onto that blast plant. There was no way that the Graves could get there.
Yeah, definitely. And there we go. This is going to be Baron started up as well. It's going to be probably, I would say, just going over to Cardi Bliss Esports. We'll see if RMT Solar can do anything to pick that up for himself, but nope, it's gone over. That is a Elder and a Baron on the team. They're probably just going to make a push for the end now. Any fight will most likely go in their favor.
Yeah, Elder, Baron, and double inhib. It's going to be very hard for Blue Team to defend here.
Yeah, I mean, I know that they can push this. They can win off this push. Or at least, like, very soon. Let's hope that they don't stall it out and have to wait for another Elder, another Baron. But you never know. This is, I would like to remind everybody, a Silver Gold League. But here we go. Yes. Actually, a big ult onto Cardi. He's taking a lot of damage. He is taken down, but that's not as much damage as Vanquest Driver is taking. And there we go. Actually manages to fall as low as Borden. And here we go. Yep, that's going to be the end push. This most likely is game. Game one will be picked up.
Just like that.
Cardi Bliss Empire. Just like that. That's all I said. Just the one push that they needed.
Yeah, outstanding play by the Fizz this game. Way to snowball. Way to really put the patron on that Lux. Really just get your team going ahead.
Yeah. Definitely a very strong performance by them. Every single lane coming out on top. There we go. Game one. In the hands to Cardi Bliss Esports. We will see everybody in game two. Everybody, welcome to match two of RMT Solar versus Cardi Bliss Empire. In the first game, we saw, although a pretty drawn-out game could have ended a little sooner, we saw a win nonetheless for Cardi Bliss Empire. So now we get to see if we manage to make it into game three, or for the caster's sake, just keep it a clean two-game series.
Two-game series, please.
Alrighty, we are jumping in once again to the champ select, the most scuffed part of my casting because I'm not good at it. Alright.
I believe in you.
I will bring it out. We have a bit of a substitution. Toddy2K, the master of coin flips, in replace of Homie. So we'll see how that goes. Toddy is, I would say, best known for his tanks, but that's all I've ever seen Toddy play. Who knows? Maybe he does play other stuff, and I'm just wrong. I'd like to see him prove me wrong if that's the case. But we right away do see an Alistar ban and a Malzahar ban. Hovered? Yes? Maybe? No? Yes. And I believe that is a first ban. They don't get it because of the sub, if I'm correct.
Okay. Gotcha.
Is that a poppy? Hold on. My eyes are bad. That is a poppy. There we go. All right. Poppy banned away. There we go. That's, yeah, poppy's pretty good. Who knows? I'm assuming that's probably a comfort pick, or poppy right now just became meta and I'm unaware of. But banning away comfort picks in these lower elo leagues are always a smart thing to do. So yeah, definitely it can be a smart ban. And is that going to be an Urgot banned away? And a Lissandra was actually banned away from RMT Solar. Lissandra, obviously right now being a very strong pick. So that's a smart ban overall. But yeah, that's Urgot gone. Go on, whatever you say. Go ahead, man.
Okay. No, go ahead. I'm good. I forgot what I was going to say. I had short-term memory loss, you know?
Yeah, no, I feel that. You're like me. You and I were like casting together. We're just gonna be like, just forgetting what we're saying. It'll turn out to be a silent cast. Which, hey, you know what? For some,
you know, it's progress.
Yeah, exactly. You know, this is my my first cast coming out of retirement for quite some time. You know, EGN basically just begged me to come back. They're like, please,
oh, absolutely, Rafa can on his knees.
Yeah, Ryan, we need your skillful casting back. EGN's just not even close to being good without it. But once again, we do see Lucian and Braum picked away opposite sides from each other. Lucian this time being picked up for Cardi Bliss Empire and Braum being picked up for RMP Solar. Is that a Draven? That is a Draven.
Oh my.
Give me the Draven. I love that pick so much. Draven can be a very strong champion. He is an immense early game bully and he can scale very well too. If the Draven is played correctly, he could be an absolute monster this game. And we are going to see the Leona picked up. So once again, another Lucian Leona lane, which did work out very well for RMT Solar last game. Obviously wasn't enough to manage to pick him up the win, but nonetheless, still did great.
I am very interested to see how these both early game laners are going to do. I think it's really going to be based off the jungle pressure that is applied here.
Yeah, and we do see the Skarner actually being picked up again for Bard One Trick. So that'll be, because the Skarner, I would say, was a very good pick last game. It worked well. They went for a more pick oriented composition. And it worked out for them. The Skarner was a strong pick last game. I imagine it should hopefully be a strong pick this game. And is Count Riara going to be back up on the Sion? He is indeed back on the Sion.
We're running it back, boys. Just adding the Draven.
Mm-hmm. And I think Leona is actually, in my opinion, better than what the Braum was last game for picks. Like, hit that, like, strong Leona ult. Skarner can go in, follow it up, and then once, you know, Skarner's doing Skarner things and pulling the enemy into the team, that's where Lucian, you know? He's strong there with that close range engage, and he'll be able to burst down the team. So I'm liking the three picks they have so far on the side of Cardi Bliss Empire. Once again, looking like going for that spicy pick comp. But for the bans, we do see Kled and Aurelia. Yes, and Aurelia and Vlad. Is it going to be Kassadin? They're hovering Kassadin. It's Kassadin. There we go. Vlad and Kassadin.
I'd love to see a big AP mage picked up here on this Hypocardi Bliss Empire to really drop the damage on top of that Leona and Skarner CC.
Yeah, definitely. Is that a... Ooh, a Hecarim.
Spicy, just like there you wanted. Are.
Yeah, there. I did say spicy. I got spicy. We got Hecarim. Hecarim, a very, very, like, impactful jungler if he gets strong early on. Going for those early engages, and Fiora, which is in fact a very good counter to Hecarim. So there you go. I do really appreciate the Fiora pick here onto Toddy. He right now is proving me wrong that he is not just a tank player. So there we go. We'll see how that goes. And is it going to be the Veigar picked up last? There's that bursty mage you wanted.
Honestly, I am a big fan of the Veigar and Leona CC pairing up. I think that's going to work out really well this game.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, Veigar, the most infinite scaling burst mage out there. So we'll see how it goes. And then Galio picked up last for Neversaw. Galio should be, I would say, a fair pick into the Veigar. It can go well. Galio is just a strong pick itself. It also can, like, kind of help defend off those picks that the Skarner is going to try and do himself. But I think out of the two compositions, I want to say that I kind of like Cardi Bliss Empires a little more because of what they managed to do with the Skarner last game. They picked a very nice comp working around the Skarner once again. And I'm imagining that Fiora is probably just going to, you know, be a classic duelist and, you know, stay in the side lanes on her own. We'll see how Toddy manages to make that play. But yeah, if Hecarim's able to snowball the early game and take advantage of Hecarim, like, becoming, like, a strong jungler, and Draven obviously winning the early lane, I think that RMT Solar can also take that for themselves.
Absolutely. As much as I would love to go to bed at a reasonable time, I'm actually going to take the upset in this game. I like RMT's strategy. They're throwing caution to the wind. They pick Draven and Hecarim. And then you got the Galio and the Sion to follow in behind that Hecarim engage. I actually really like where the comp is headed this game.
Yeah. And I mean, the problem, though, I will say, like, if they're really putting a lot of baskets into the Hecarim kind of Draven pool, because they don't have a lot of damage dealers outside of those two, if the damage dealers, you know, start losing lane, say if Skarner is able to go down and abuse the Draven and, like...
Oh,
you know,
it's over at that point.
The bot lane
if Draven and Hecarim don't snowball, it's over.
Yeah, it's over. So it's really all depending on how Borden plays in the Hecarim and how Tyler Success plays on the Draven.
Do we have the loading screen yet?
We do, in fact, have the good old loading screen. Hecarim, okay. Opting to bring for Predator. Very strong choice there. Probably want to go for the damage. He is bringing Ghost as well. Predator, Ghost, Hecarim was so good with old Celerity. I imagine he's still bringing Celerity to get that extra movement speed. He's just going to be incredibly fast. But with, like, the AP or the AD scaling with old Celerity was insane on, like...
Oh, yeah.
So definitely still will be strong, just not... as strong.
I gotta say, again, we see that same situation where the mage decides to take Arcane Comet instead of Dark Harvest, but I do love the fact that he takes Cleanse into this Galio. I think that is a great choice. That's really going to help him to survive these early lane ganks where the Galio pulls out that Flash Tome.
Yeah, definitely. And, like, the Veigar here, as controversial as a pick it may be, you could able to opt out for more comfortable early game burst mages. It kind of just works out with the comp that they have. If Leona manages to hit like a good 2 or 3 man ult, Veigar can put the cage around there and that kind of extends them being trapped and will allow, you know, the Veigar to do more damage and the Lucian to get in there and do a bit of damage. If Fiora's around, able to do Fiora things. So I think it can be a smart pick with the composition. We'll just see how they manage to play with it. levels.
Yeah, my biggest issue is if that Veigar is ever going to get to that late game stage. They've got this early game comp here on red side, and if they get going, Veigar's not going to do much.
Yeah, exactly. They're really banking on winning the early game, giving time for Veigar to scale, and then kind of moving away with that. But we are in game. Let me once again quickly introduce the blue side myself. So on the blue side, we do have Cardi on Leona. Apologize, it's not in order, but I'll fix that for myself in a second. But Cardi on Leona, Fried Chicken Leg on the Veigar, Bard One Trick on Skarner, Chaunty 2K on the Fiora, and Bliss on Lucian.
Yeah, and then going over to the other side here, we have Count Riara, I think is what we decided on, is on Sion. Yeah, we have Borden 23 on that Hecarim. Galio, or Never Saw on that Galio. Tyler is Success on that Draven, and Bangbus Driver on that Braum.
There we go. And pretty standard starts. A little Skarner deciding to go for the top side of the map, bringing Toddy down. Toddy maybe being able to, a bit of a late start, so might lose a bit of farm on his side, which is quite unfortunate. But hey, it happens. And I would like to say, I would like to have this game being brought to the attention of the junglers. It all depends on what they do this game, we'll say. How are they able to make use of their advantages? Will Borden be an early game monster and get scaling as Hecarim? Or will he kind of just flop, and will the Skarner once again be able to take control of the game?
I'd love to see this Hecarim get out some early ganks. All lanes are honestly very gankable for the Hecarim this game. Every lane has that CC.
I understand, agree with that. And so we'll just kind of have to see what happens. A bit of a seeming like they're going to trade in the top lane here. Yeah. Nothing too crazy.
Sorry. Yeah, Sion might struggle with these Fiora procs early, but you know, in that late game, he's just going to be untouchable.
As we wait for me to once again sync up with my streamer, I think we're good now. Oh no, now I'm way ahead. Hold on.
Uh-oh. Oh yeah, I'm 20 seconds ahead as well.
Yeah, no worries. All right, well, luckily for us, nothing too crazy is going down. We're just gonna kind of wait it out. Hopefully, you know, come on team, be respectful to us good old casters. Just wait for us to to sync up.
We're getting there.
And I think we're good.
Yep, I am good as well.
I am indeed good. Okay, perfect. And just in time, because we see a bit of a trade going on the top side of the map and the bottom side. Bard One Trick trying to do something. Tries to use his E or something on Cardia's own ability, but that was mostly just because the Braum decided to flash away, get out of there. And there we go. We got some scrimmages. Bard One Trick already trying to make work done on the map, and we still really haven't seen the Hecarim, although he's hovering top. He wants to do something.
That is an early flash blown by the Braum there.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, they looked like he wanted to make a play into Toddy there, but decided to opt in to not. Saying, looking at Count Riara and being like, all right, you're a little low, you're a Sion. We'll wait it out. Toddy's still full HP. Might be able to blow a summoner, if anything, but I'm just going to take the opportunity back, go grab some farm, come back stronger, maybe we can get more out of a play.
Yeah, absolutely. Never anything wrong with blowing that flash.
Yes, exactly. There is never anything wrong with blowing that flash. You could, in my opinion, like, you know, always going for that flash, good. Even if you think you can't get a kill, go in there, get some pressure going back for your, like, your lane. Get that flash going, and there you go. But, I mean, going back for, say, like, coming for something more is also, you know, it's a strategy in itself. Could work out. But Count Riara actually taking a lot of damage into this Fiora, which I assume is going to be the fate of this lane for a little bit. And Never Saw actually taking a good chunk of damage from Fried Chicken Leg there, getting caught into the cage.
Yeah, big thing to point out here, if we take a look at Veigar's stacks, already at 28 stacks, that is 51 AP, and we're only 5 minutes into the game.
Yeah, definitely. Very, very good for the Veigar. And TP blown for Sion, he is back, and we do see a gank attempt. A good cleanse denies everything. Fried Chicken Leg gets out of there. Doesn't even have to blow his flash. He understood what was going to happen. He knew what he had to do. He is out of there.
Yeah, that is one of the struggles of this Galio into the more passive Veigar.
Mm-hmm.
Is that you are going to have to give up those stacks early game. Is that even if you're going to be a strong magic resist Galio late game, this Veigar is going to have that magic pen to really tear you down.
Yeah, exactly. And here we go. Bard one trick actually forced a flash out here. Curdy goes in to try to defend his jungler and just finds himself caught out, taking a whole lot of damage. He doesn't have flash himself either. He's got to leave. That's a whole lot of damage on either side, but no picks.
More sounds continue to be blown, though.
Yeah, I mean, summoners, if anything, are good. That was a good attempt onto the both of them. And I want to say, I was going to make this comment before, with how, like, early game orientated you want this Draven to be. He is kind of struggling in this lane a little bit, level behind, missing out on farm, but he is going to try to do something here, move up a bit, because he knows his Hecarim's around. There we go.
Yeah, he is only keeping even in CS, but it's hard, because just as much Draven is early game, this Leona Lucian is early game as well, so it's really hard to get that pull away early victory.
Yeah, exactly. You know, Draven wants to just kind of go in and do damage, but Leona's there to stop him. Lucian's there to just kind of damage him out. So, tough lane for him, but we'll see. You know, we're still only 7 minutes in the game. He has the opportunity to get sailing, you know, get those adoration stacks and just do Draven things.
Yeah, Fiora already has picked up that team match. She's got a 20 CS lead on the Sion. She's just going to be able to really keep abusing him. There's no foreseeable future right now that it's coming anytime soon where this Sion is going to be able to match her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, being doubled in CS, that is tough. And Fiora with Demolish is just able to take a free plating there. And Kamurara, you can't stop that. Toddy is playing this lane very, very well and using his advantage there. We'll see if Borden is able to, you know, maybe do anything in the top lane to help Kamurara out or opt in to maybe get some other lanes scaling. And just kind of, you know, leave his tank to just farm up on his own and do tank things.
Yeah, we got that good side of the coin flip this time. It's got to feel good for Cardi plus Empire.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And, I mean, never saw, you know, kind of keeping ahead and farm into this Veigar lane. I think Galio here will be a decent pick to kind of help him survive in lane, because obviously Galio, you know, he has a little bit of extra magic resist to help him in mages. Just a little bit. A little bit's enough, though. Every little bit counts. And yeah, the bot lane still keeping perfectly even in farm for the most part. Both of these laners saying that, hey, no, I'm the better laner. Alright. So.
Yeah, I mean, definitely, it's going to be hard for either side to really come away without that jungle pressure. Both junglers have tried, but these haven't quite been able to connect.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see that first dragon is in Mountain? Not quite super high priority early game, maybe to get that turret plating?
No, I mean, I would say for the team of, like, Cardi Blist Empire, you know, kind of banking on, say, like, the Veigar late game damage, taking a Mountain would be kind of handy for them. But yeah, obviously not a dragon you want to like prioritize immensely early on, but still, dragons are good to pick up.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. And they are playing a bit of a vision game around. They're making plays around the bot, so I think the teams want this. And yeah, we do see a gank attempt onto the bot lane. The alt dropping down for Neversaw. They are going to pick up first blood. Bang Bus Driver takes it for himself. And we still have a scrap going on here. Bard one trick finding himself a little low, Blitz going, but oh no!
Ooh, there's Veigar.
Yeah, he has to flash away, and that was Sion blown in the top lane there. Toddy 2k doing a whole lot of damage, really managed to pick up the kill. He just misses! Oh no, that's gotta feel bad.
That's the filter.
Sion living by the skin of his teeth there. Neversong, trapped in that cage, trying to dance, avoid that damage as much as he can.
Yeah, I mean, quick recap of what just went down there. Big thing is that the Braum did pick up that first blood, but again, we see the situation where the support picks up the early kills, especially when you have that Draven. It's not what you want to see.
Yeah, I mean, kills are kills, right? Like, at least it's good to get the gold on your side of the team. But yeah, especially when you have a Draven, it is very nice to get that gold in the Draven. He can get those adoration stacks and just become strong like Draven's supposed to be. And Toddy, he manages to pick up 3 platings for himself. That is a good chunk of gold onto the Fiora. He's going to back and pick himself up some goods in a second.
Yeah, massive gold lead in the top lane. This is starting to get out of hand.
A little bit, yeah. Like I said, Toddy, I have not seen this man on anything other than a tank, but he's proven to me right now that he is more than just a tank player, so there we go.
Yeah, looking at vision real quick. Red team, not a whole lot of vision in the river. However, as I say that, Braum looks to go take that Skarner by going to what the name is off the top of my head. The Skarner thing, so that we'll get a little more control in the river.
Oh yeah, good old abilities in League of Legends. I have been playing this game since Season 2. I have casted for a little bit of time now, and I still don't care to learn the names. And we are going to see a pick here. Fried Chicken Leg manages to get a kill onto the Hecarim there. That is going to be very nice for that Veigar.
Yeah, good old jungler. Love that you give the kill to the mid laner there. Big fan of that to get that Veigar snowballing earlier.
Yeah, exactly. Handing the kill over to him on a silver platter, going, hey, you know what? See this Hecarim? He's yours. Go ahead. Take the gold. Take the stacks. Do what you can. And a very, very good parry by Toddy. Able to make that trade go in his favor as well. He is 50 CS ahead in this lane. This is just... it's getting, could be getting a little out of hand. And he manages to pick up the... another plating, going for the final plating himself, but he's actually tanking the tower. Toddy here, tanking a little too much. Yeah, Sion's got the ult there. He has the ultimate himself, though. He might be actually able to turn this. Toddy doing work. Ultimate shot, he's got the healing, but he's still tanking tower. Forced to flash away, but will fall. That is a trade kill in the top lane. Played well, I would say, by the both of them. Toddy, few misplays. Sion, few misplays. Hey, but they both died.
Yeah, Toddy almost getting a little bit greedy for that final turret kill there, but Count Riara very well played. Gets the turret damage onto that Fiora. Manages to turn it around.
Yeah, definitely. Good for him at least, you know, like getting at least a little bit of gold under his name being, you know, that far behind in gold. But on the flip side, his opposing laner also got the same amount of gold, so...
yeah, and he actually loses minions because of that wave pushed to the Fiora there.
Yeah, and here we go, a big ultimate onto Bliss. The Hecarim will pick up that kill, and now Cardi forced to flash it away, doing whatever he can, but there's the slow. They will actually manage to get the stun. Cardi getting that ult off, but Neversaw is here to ult himself, and boom, that is a kill for the Galio. But, once again, the tower, he's picking off victims.
Tower looks like the MVP right now.
Yeah, Tower MVP. They will get a good bit of plating off of this tower. Unfortunately, there is no way this... well, I won't say no way, but a very small chance that they actually do get the tower here because the platings just get stronger and stronger the more you damage them. And I think, yeah, Toddy did get the first tower up there in the top lane.
Just took away that red buff, too. He's really abusing that lead.
Yeah. And turret plating has fallen, so this is giving Fried Chicken Leg and Toddy a good opportunity to go for this mid lane tower. But I'm thinking, yeah, Bard One Trick says he wants the Herald instead, which I would say is a good idea.
Yeah, very solid pickup. No way to contest.
Yeah, so they get that Herald now, which hopefully should transfer into a tower somewhere on the map. Looking like... I was going to say looking like top lane, but no, I don't know why it would look like top lane. They were not in the top lane.
Got it for that T2.
You're going to have to excuse me. No, but here we go. Again, once again, a lot of damage going on to Bliss. There's Draven doing Draven things. Picked up the full Bloodthirster first. I don't know. I don't play a lot of Draven, so I can't tell you what's good and what's not good.
I can't say. As far as I knew, it was Stormraiser, but I mean...
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Fighting their dude to get that early sustain.
In my opinion, it was always Stormraiser or Death Dance, but I guess Bloodthirster makes just as much sense as Death Dance does, so...
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we do start to see those first items coming out. Those are going to play a big impact for these champions.
Mm-hmm. Borden actually having to force to use his ultimate to escape because he realized that he was getting collapsed on by the Veigar and Fiora. Here we go. They're trying to do something in the bot lane there, but Skarner is actually around to turn this play around. Predator pop, but no, he's going to just instead go and grab that the pink ward. Just give bot lane a good old scare.
Yeah, if we continue to watch this Veigar scaling, it's going to be a big theme all game. He's up to 114 stacks.
Yeah.
And there's not much this Galio can do about it.
Yeah, Toddy wants to fight this Sioner, but he's not able to. Oh yeah, he got that vital now. Ultimate dropping. Will he manage to get all four? He's going for the dive under tower. Toddy, you're missing. Oh, and there we go. A huge misplay by Toddy2k. He falls. Whoa. My voice just got really deep. All right, huge ultimate though. Bye there, Bang Bus Driver finding himself in a bit of a pickle. Bard one trick, manages to pick up a kill for himself. That is a kill. Well, one for two, I believe that was. Yeah, one for two. I mean, not even a one for two. Toddy died up in the top lane, so over two technically, but we'll say one for two. And that is that Mountain Jake picked up for that team that I said would probably make the most use out of it.
And again, we start to see that support got that 450 bounty again. It always manages to happen in these games.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate because he'd love to translate these early kills into a little bit more value.
Yeah, exactly. Either, like, none of the ADCs, you know, they're both kind of slacking in the kills and their supports are just picking them up for themselves. They want the gold. And here we go. Herald will manage to pick up the tower. It is two towers to 0 for Hardy Bliss Empire.
Yeah, these greedy support players, man. What can you say?
Yeah, geez, man. Silly supports. Who plays support?
I think it's a fake role. I'm pretty sure it's just bots that play. Let's be real.
I mean, I main support for a season. You know, I was a good old support player.
I'm sorry. It must have been a really tough time in your life. I hope you're doing better.
Hey man, support was kind of fun in that time, but I think support played a bit of a different role than what it does now.
Oh yeah, absolutely. The game has changed so much over the years.
Yeah. Well, here we go. No, I love all as an ADC player and a top laner, but I love my supports. I have to respect them. If it weren't for them, I'd be inting every game. And as our streamer says, I was poking fun at her, saying who's a support player. Yeah, she said, that's right, because I have to be humble with my supports.
As an arrogant mid laner, I refuse to apologize for my words.
That's respectable, alright. There we go, we are going to see a bit of trading, bit of stuff. Golden lead still in the favor of Cardi Bliss Empire after our whole debacle on support. And a huge, huge pick onto Tyler is success. Bliss managing to pick up his first kill of the game.
There we go, Lucian getting the kill this time.
And that's pretty big because that's a lot of Adoration stacks just gone now for the Draven. But here we go, Sion and the Braum, they say, what did you do to my support? We're here to back you up. And Neversaw managing to pick up the kill with the ultimate. Cardi doing what he can, but the CC is just too much. Toddy tries to teleport in, but he's just forced to back off. Unlucky that you can't cancel that anymore. But look what we have going on in the mid lane. They're still pushing up, picking up the tower for themselves. It is 5 towers to 1 now. They trade kills for towers, pushing their tower advantage even further.
Yeah, much quicker paced game this game. Obviously, you got to see that when you ever have this aggressive bot lane and this Fiora in the top lane. And you love to see the action, and it's really hard to say who's been coming out on top.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's an obvious thing. Definitely, Cardi Bliss is coming out on top. They're still holding the gold lead, even though being kills because that turtle they have is just very, very immense. But Toddy finding himself a little out of position here, being caught out. There's four members on the bot side of the map down here to punish him. He can only stop so much CC. And there we go. Teller 6 success manages to pick up his first kill of the game.
Yeah, and we see that kill thrown over to the Draven that time. It's a good sign.
Yeah, definitely. That's a good gold onto Draven. Hopefully able to get him scaling a bit. I would say very nice pick there by RMT Solar. Very nice. Seeing that Toddy zone. And Toddy, I mean, despite him being 1-3, he's still got a lot of pressure going in this game. And a huge engage by Neversaw and Borden. Fantastic. They managed to pick up a kill for themselves there. And there we go, another one. Fried Chicken Leg actually managing to pick himself up a kill. Wait a minute. Yeah, they go 1-1. I'm sorry. My game tabbed out in the middle of that.
And Vega really starting to do the damage. He absolutely destroyed. Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm. And Fried Chicken Leg managing to pick himself another kill. Toddy's got the ult trapped on Kart Riera. He's got vitals. The stun goes down. He's forced to flash off. One more vital to go. He does pick up the ultimate, but he manages to get the kill. Shutdown gold. I don't know how much it was, but hey, at least it's something. Toddy picking himself up a second kill, which will help him greatly. That engage was so nice from Borden and Neversaw, but it was turned the opposite way of what they expected it to go.
Yeah, we just see on this Vagar, just like the last game when he's snowballing on that Fizz, he's up to a 700 gold shutdown. Let's go ahead and quickly check out those stacks. I believe he's over 200. Yes, just hitting that 200 bonus AP. That's huge.
It is huge. This Fried Chicken Leg, once again, having a huge bounty on him. He is a strong, strong player, we'll say. Two games in a row. But yeah, good play by Cardibus Esports. I think they actually got the upper hand there. Managed to even themselves up in kills and have about a 3k gold lead, a little less than that. Yeah, I'm not... About 3k gold lead.
Solid.
More than a 3k gold lead. I don't know why I said less. Don't mind my math.
It's close enough. You know, math is difficult.
Yeah. You know, just basic math is still too hard for me. But yeah, that is another mountain going to be picked up for Cardibus Esports. And Bangrush Driver actually taking a lot of damage from Veigar. Fried Chicken, it's just a monster now. He was not able to shut him down early on, and he's just going to do Veigar things.
Yeah, quickly, let's check out what he's building into. I believe he's going to pick up that Banshee's Veil. And then if I were the Veigar here, I would definitely start building into either that Morello's or that Void Staff to really just continue to counteract all this MR being built on the side of this red team. And I feel like at that point, there's really no way you can stop him.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So we'll see how the way they go. It's, again, getting to that point where the Baron Dan should be starting up. And as soon as they say that, see a ping on the blue side of the map to kind of go around there. Start prioritizing vision, because once again, they get the Baron and they're going to be able to extend their gold lead even further, which, as it happened last game, should hopefully bring them to the win.
Yeah, definitely got to think that they have a lot of zone control with that Skarner and that Veigar cage. At the same time, you got the risk of a hard engage.
But here we go. Toddy 2K once again finding himself in a bit of a weird position. Cannot stop that amount of CC. And Fried Chicken Leg also finding himself in a situation, but the team's here to back him up. Will they be able to trade kill for kill, or were they able to get out? It's a lot of damage going on to Bangwest Driver, but Neversaw goes in, gets a huge three-man taunt. But the ultimate going down, Neversaw, will he fall? He does. Bard one trick picking up the kill. The Threshmer going in. Oh my goodness, Fried Chicken Leg managing to pick off Borden. And there we go, the tables have turned. Once again, a huge engage. Somehow turns out to be in Cardibus Esports' favor. They go 2-1.
Yeah, I believe Veigar hit that 4-man W fading away, and the health bars just dropped so quickly. It's really hard to recover from that.
Exactly. I mean, I have to commend Neversaw with hitting that taunt. It was very nice, but it just wasn't enough. The damage coming out from Fried Chicken Leg is huge. And that's going to be mid lane tower most likely falling here. They're going to go for it. Although I think it might have been smarter for them to start the Baron, but hey, can't diss a decision.
Tower is a tower.
Tower is a tower, yeah.
think this Veigar is really getting to a point where you have to just throw everything you have at him. Otherwise, he will one-shot your entire team.
Mm-hmm. And he's flashing that mastery, too. He knows. He knows how strong he is now. Yeah, he's feeling very good. But yeah, there we are. They're immediately going to go and try and set up Vision on the Baron. Ooh, actually getting spotted out by the ward. Horden knows he's there, but still opting to kind of just get Vision. He's playing a brave game there. You don't want to underestimate that Veigar's damage.
Yeah, absolutely. A little risky, but the Veigar at half mana, at half health, felt confident in his own abilities that he'd be okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we do see a solid 4.5k gold lead for Cardi Bliss Esports. It's looking very nice on them. But like I said, you know, there's big shutdowns onto Veigar. A pretty decent shutdown onto Skarner now too. So one team fight once again could turn the pace of this game.
Yeah, at the same time, you're really starting to see these CS leads from the side of Cardi Bliss Esports really start to get a little bit out of hand, except for in that bot lane.
Yeah, exactly. And here we go. I mean, Draven's still doing a lot of damage to Bliss. He can't do the full amount of damage that he wanted to do. And we are going to see Toddy try and fight Neversaw. He walks right back into the taunt. Takes a lot of damage, but now we see an engage in the bot lane. But a huge, huge Veigar wall stops everything. And now an incredible Cardi ultimate. And we're going to see the way this fight goes. Here we go. Cardi actually taking a whole lot of damage. But Neversaw is here to try and disengage, back his team up. And Toddy still in the bot lane, but that was a fantastic Veigar wall that completely denied that Hecarim's engage and the rest of the team able to follow up. And somehow, I mean, we saw it go right to the mid lane. Toddy survives walking right back into the Galio taunt.
Yeah, absolutely. This game is on the back of Fried Chicken, like, really starting to pull away.
Mm-hmm. And he gets a double stun here, and that's going to be him picking up another kill onto Bangwest Driver. That should be the inhibitor falling. Neversaw trying to do what he can, but his taunts just aren't enough. Toddy there doing damage onto Borden. Manages to pick up the kill, so that's his ult.
This might be game.
Yeah. Neversaw finding himself really low, trying to do what he can, but boom, another Leona ultimate picks up the kill. That is a double kill for Toddy. They're going to do everything they can to push for the end here. Taking the towers. There we go. That is one. Will it be two? Count Riara doing what he can, but he's just not tanky enough. The stun dropping. And that is two towers. Can they go for the Nexus here? I believe that they can. Yeah,